This video is an overview on more report options with TechConnect. So here we're assuming that you can make a very basic report. What we'll cover is setting up report conditions based on a different table, customizing visualizations, insert and stay, and using reports as data sources. As always, I can get to the reports screen by searching the All menu for report, going to View/Run. I'm going to open my report, My Incidents in the Last 90 Days. My current two conditions are based on fields in the incidents table which I am pulling from. What if I'd like to filter my report based on information in a different table in TechConnect? For example, there is a table which shows the elapsed time of how long it took to close the incident. I know that the elapsed ticket time is in a field in the task SLA task table. To add conditions to my report based on other tables in TechConnect, I'm going to look in this conditions section and open related list conditions. Here, I can choose a new table to make conditions for. I know that elapsed time is in task SLAs, so I'm going to search and click task SLA task. And now I have a standard conditions filter. I'm going to set my condition to be look at the field actual elapsed time greater than 3 days. So now my report is going to show incidents that were opened in the last 90 days that are assigned to Susie Ramondi. Then TechConnect is going to look in the task table and filter on actual elapsed time is greater than 3 days. And I'm going to click Run. Note that still, elapsed time does not appear in my report. TechConnect will check elapsed time for the incidents, but the report is still only pulling actual data from the incidents table. If I instead want to pull from my task table, I can click back to get to the Data tab and change which table this report is looking at. However, then I will have to rebuild all of my conditions. Switching gears, what if you have a visualization like a pie chart and you'd like to customize it, like changing the colors? You can use the back and next buttons to go back to the type panel on the left. Maybe I'm going to scroll up and choose pie chart. I'm going to click Run so that my report updates. Now I have my incidents in the last 90 days and the sections are the actions that were taken on them. Now I'm going to click Next to get to configure, because maybe instead of having the different pieces of the pie chart be the action that was taken, I'd like the pieces of the pie chart to be the service that each incident was on. So I'm going to come to the configure panel here on the left, and where I have group by default it's action. I'm just going to click that and I'm going to choose service. Then when I click Run, I now have an updated pie chart for what service is being offered. Now that I've configured to show the service I want, maybe I'd like to change the colors. I can click Next to get to the Style tab. And here, perhaps I can say Set Palette. Click this little magnifying glass. Maybe instead of blues, I'd like greens. So I can choose green, dark to light, and click Run, and my chart updates. When you're looking at the palettes, keep accessibility in mind. For example, many individuals are red-green colorblind, so instead of making different sections of your report red or green, you might pick shades of green or shades of blue. These are just some of the options for creating your report. Don't be afraid to click around and try things. Clicking Run always displays your report as you've currently configured it, and if you get lost, you can exit out of the report creation screen without saving it. Now let's talk about insert and stay. Insert is just another way to say save as. When you have a report, what you can do is you can change the name of the report here. So instead of my incidents in the last 90 days, I might call this pie chart of incidents by service. And in the Save dropdown in the top right, I'm going to click this little arrow and I have Insert or Insert and Stay. Insert is going to save the report as a new report, so save as, and then take me back to the main reports list. So if I click that, I get a little pop-up letting me know the report was created, and then I can go to the My Reports tab, and here is my new report, Pie Charts of Incidents by Service, and my previous report, My Incidents in the Last 90 Days, still there. So insert is save as, and when you click it, you get taken back to the reports list. Alternatively, if I come to a report and I give it a new name, such as incident list for me, and I come to the little drop down next to save, insert and stay is going to again save as the report, make new report, but stay on this page so I can keep working on this report. So if I click that, it tells me report created, incident list for me, but I'm still here working on this report. If I click on the arrow to go back to the main report list and I look at my reports, I now have incident list for me, my incidents in the last 90 days, and pie chart of incidents by service. Lastly, we're going to talk about using existing reports as data sources. So if I go to create a report, on the first screen where I choose my source type, instead of picking table, and then, for example, pulling from the incidents table, I can choose data source. And what a data source is instead of looking at a single specific table in TechConnect, you can look at something customized. For example, if you already have a report of all incidents assigned to TTS, you can use that as a data source so that you don't have to add that condition to your report. It's a good way to clean up your conditions or know where you're starting from. And when I click a report, it gives me a description of what the report is and some conditions that have been applied to it. So this is what's already in the report, so I do not have to add these filters to my conditions. So this tells me that this pulls from the incident table and removes duplicate incidents, spam, and things that might have sensitive data. I'll give my report a name like test pulling from TTS incident report, and I'll click next. So now when I start creating my report, TechConnect tells me our data source is a report called TTS incident, which already has some conditions built in, not a duplicate incident, not spam, and doesn't have sensitive data. And if I click the filter icon to open the condition builder, these conditions aren't listed here because they're built into the data source. I can use this as a starting point. So for example, I could say opened after the last 60 days and click run. Using reports as data sources is really helpful if you're continuously making reports with the same couple filters. If I'm always adding the conditions, not a duplicate incident, not spam, doesn't have sensitive data, I can build that as a report, set that report as a data source, and now always start from there. So we're making a template that's our starting point to keep going from. And you don't have to be the one to have created this report as a data source. Not everyone has permissions to save a report as a data source. But for example, this report, TTS incident, is a report someone that's not me created, that's just available for me to use. Someone created this report, saved it as a data source, and made it available across TechConnect. So if I go back to the data screen, I can open up the data source dropdown and see what do I already have access to. So for example, incidents.open, if I click on that, it tells me this is incidents where the condition is active equals true. So you can click through and say what reports already exist that I can use. And those are some more advanced things that you can do with TechConnect.